Hey, what's up, guys? Before this Modern Warfare 3 info video begins, I have another question for you guys to answer in the comment section below. And the question is, what do you think of the two new maps, and which do you think is better, and why? So you can answer this question in the comment section below. And remember that if you enjoyed this video and find it informative, all I ask in return is that you click the like button and favorite this video if you want to, and subscribe to my channel for more Modern Warfare 3 content and news in the future. Hey, what's up, guys? I got some more Modern Warfare 3 news for you guys, this time concerning the Modern Warfare 3 1.08 patch notes. Now, yesterday, with the release of the DLC for the Xbox 360 Elite Premium members, Modern Warfare 3's creative strategist, Robert Bowling, went on the Machinima Respawn live stream, and he detailed exactly what was released in the 1.08 patch, what was nerfed, what was fixed, what was changed. And the first thing that he mentioned was the shotguns, how they nerfed the Striker. Now, by nerfing the Striker, what they did was they reduced the spread and the damage, they reduced the amount of pellets it uses from 9 to 6, and they buffed all the other shotguns to 9 pellets. So now all the other shotguns besides the Striker uses 9 pellets, and the Striker only uses 6 pellets. And this was a long way to patch, a lot of players were waiting for, because players who used the Striker would just run through enemy players left and right, and it was way too easy. And tonight, I used the Striker a little bit on Modern Warfare 3, and you could definitely feel the change in patch, because before it would be one-shot kills left and right. Now, sometimes it takes 2 to 3 shots, depending on the distance. Now, for the akimbo, a lot of players were complaining about the FMG9 akimbos. However, Infinity Ward took it upon themselves to lower the fire rate for all akimbo weapons, not only the FMG9s. So, if this fixes the FMG9 situation with it being overpowered, then that's great. If not, then there's going to be some more patching needed to be done in the future. Infinity Ward also fixed the theater mode, because a lot of players were having trouble using theater mode. And the fixes that were included was trouble viewing clips is now fixed. People who used to get error 7 shouldn't get it anymore. And also black screens. There was talk about players getting black screens while using the theater mode. That's been fixed. And also YouTube uploads from the theater mode should be 100 times faster than it was since launch. Now for general fixes and tweaks. The first thing that Robert Bowling stated was that they had tweaks to lag compensation and host advantage, and now you should have better. You should be better when you host if you have a fast connection. Also, there's general network improvements, bug fixes, and there was no specifics on which bugs were fixed. Improvements to the banning system and support for the new maps, obviously. And also, last night the Infinity Ward team made it more possible for DLC maps to show up in rotation. Because for those of you guys who have the Elite playlist, you know that sometimes the Elite maps would even show up. So now when you're playing in those Elite playlists, the DLC maps should have more of a chance of showing up. So that's all the patch notes I got for you guys today concerning the 1.08 patch. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and found it informative. And if you did, don't forget to click that like button, favorite this video, and subscribe to my channel for more Modern Warfare 3 content and news in the future. Till next time, peace.